I think Democrats are going to get what they want. And I think that this is no longer about getting him out of office. Mm-hmm. It is putting on the record for everyone to see, whether you agree with it or not, that we followed the directions that the founders have put down and said, if you think something is happening, it's the same with the not the whisperer law. My God,
the whistleblower.
You know, yeah. there are things that have been put into place so that people
that
can
want him removed, though. Like, okay, I do have Democratic. I think there's a swath, probably.
There are a lot of people who, I guess what I'm saying is, regardless of whether he goes or not, the fact that we are, as Americans, entitled to question the actions of this man sitting in office, and their job, Congress, Senate, their job is to say, if they're saying there's something wrong, we need to make sure there's not, because you should be the pinnacle. Now, we know they're human beings, but you should be the pinnacle. Your dad was the pinnacle, you know? Whether I agreed with him about everything was never the point. The point was, I never questioned where he stood for the country. When you start questioning where a president actually stands for the country, whether you're right, left, or center, it's a problem.
It's always supposed to be country before self. And this is about, it's supposed to be about oversight, right? It's supposed to be about a separation of powers. It's supposed to be about no one is above the law. And I think this you know, House is taking its oath seriously and is being guided by the Constitution.
This letter could have been an opportunity for him to get the upper hand here.
But I think we need to stop living in Never Neverland where we think that he's going to be presidential in that way. And I think part of the problem with everyone in politics, as you just said, Whoopi, that a lot of things have gone out the wayside. I'm no longer not living in the present. I can't expect professional presidential ethical behavior anymore. Mm-hmm. I'm living in the politics of this and telling Democrats that if you want him out, and I feel the rage of Democrats all day, every day, as soon as I leave my apartment, I know you want him out, or at least a lot of you do. And I just don't know if this is the way to do it, because once it gets to the Senate, I don't think Mitch McConnell, as you say every day, Joy,
is
going to do this. And I know it's going to be on the record, but I also know you want him pulled out of the White House in golden handcuffs. I know that about you.
I feel very good about today that we're doing this. Mm-hmm. And I also think that the Democrats need to push this idea that they are holding up witnesses. That we need to hear in the trial in the Senate. We need to hear from Mulvaney. Yeah. We need to hear from Bolton. We need to hear from Giuliani. The fact that those people are not going to be witnesses means that they have something to hide. Americans need to know that. Republicans need to know that. Mm-hmm. Republicans need to know that their country is being misused by the people in charge.
And I think 71% of Americans want witnesses.
Republicans and say we're going to bring people that we want.
Yeah,
everyone can say let's bring.
It has to be germane to the trial. But the bottom line is, we did it for Clinton.
Yes.
We did it for with Nixon.
Yes.
Do the same thing. Follow the same steps.
Same rule.
There's no one rule for you and another rule. Follow the same steps, because whether you're a Democrat or Republican or someone who is in the middle, we're all Americans, and these are the laws.
Yeah.
If you're taking us out this way, then you got to take everybody out that way. Will it happen? Who can say? Who can say?